so the general public has a deep fear that in the next election, which is going to come up in 2014, will the voting machines...
2014, not 2012.
So there is a fear if the voting machines will resurface again. So the general public, they have, I think around 80% of them have pinned their hopes on you, sir.
Yeah, I'll tell you what the situation is. I proved it in the Delhi High Court in my writ petition that this is riggable on two bases. Number one, the electronic voting machine, the brain is something called a microcontroller chip. This microcontroller chip is produced by a Japanese company on contract from the Electronic Corporation of India. I contacted the Japanese company and asked them, do you use the same chip in Japanese elections? They said, are you mad? We will never touch an electronic voting machine. In Japan, we use ballot papers. Same thing is true with England. They use ballot papers. Same thing is true with Germany, where the Supreme Court struck down the use of electronic voting machines. So I pointed out to the court that the most important thing is in the hands of a foreigner. And foreigners may like another foreigner to rule this country. So how do I know that the chip is correctly recording it? I think that as a, for transparency, this should not be allowed. That's one. Second, I did not contest 2009 election because the electronic voting machine was being used. But I did contest 2004 election, where everybody thought I was going to win. I had won the previous election, and you know, I was very popular in Madurai. But I found that I lost, and I found that out of the 1500 polling booths, in 500 polling booths I got 0, 1 or 2 votes. So I told the court, how is it possible that a party which has 5 polling booth members, and all of them are loyal party workers because they depend on their future on me. If I get elected, then they'll be able to get, do all kinds of work which, you know, they get social status as my worker. They and their family will mean 25 votes. I cannot get less than 25 votes per booth. How can I get 0 vote? Is it possible? So court was convinced. Then finally, court asked me, is there any way we can keep the electronic voting machine and amend it in such a way that you will be satisfied? So I said, yes, there is one way, and that way the Election Commission has to follow. There is an act called Information Technology Act. Information Technology Act Section 11 says that any electronic voting machine, if you punch in data, if anyone punches data, he has a right to receive a receipt. So if I go to an ATM and I punch withdrawal, then I must get a receipt. So I said, if the electronic voting machine after I press gives me a receipt, you voted for so and so, serial number so and so, and then I tear that receipt and go and put it in the box, because if I take it outside, some gunda will catch me and, you know, say you voted against me. So put it in there, and when there's a dispute, the machine will not be run again, but the ballot box will be counted. That I am acceptable. So Election Commission agreed that we will do it. On 14th December, they are to report. I said that till that election, there should be no electronic voting machine. Till that amendment is made, correction is made, a printing unit is put into the machine, electronic voting machine should not be used. Court said there is no big election coming just now. You know, here and there by election we want to let it go on. But before UP election, I expect that the electronic voting machine will have this extra unit that when you punch, you will get a receipt. then it is very more, much, still you can do, but it is much more difficult. Absolutely, no question, I will not let go, don't worry.